So now we will read from the text.
Da, tamba da tamje kembe, asa nego gutuja, ngantola dene. Ane thardu gutuja, tamba da tamje kembe koma tuja ke tamga. Jindichigita dengengi, ane lamadi kashmushare es, tene indusane, tamba manzubena, si lapta yanyi seari, kikin yanyi ilta, ane rali gituwa, ope jina shincheni, ane dinidivita tamba. Any deep dung gangi, Lama the Saints are school days. The reason that the gum did it. Any jiri in the shining singing, Jumden Degi, do it Nagy Lama, eh? Any yigi song of Dodge Tegway, Dodge Loving Parky, and Lame Cashew, Lame Vesher, Kundakan School of Titi, Sunshi Yavari. Down the gum did any Tama the Tajin of Koma Dung Gangi. 타바트지침도 고반 쪽에 당나 땡내기 아니 왕도 제네 다 알람에 친이 숨으잖아요 안 더디게는 숨이 최초살 송이 말이
So we were talking about the qualities that are relevant on the part of the teacher and particularly a teacher who is going to give instruction to the students on the basis of the actual instruction of the Buddha all of which are aimed at bringing about the realization of our temporary, immediate aim of gaining a fortunate rebirth into a higher realm and the long-term and ultimate aim of attainment of liberation. And since this is the teaching, the person who is imparting the instruction needs to possess the qualities that are necessary for imparting such actual instruction. And so here, generally, and because the quality and the effectiveness of the teaching would, you know, to a large extent, depend upon the quality of the teacher. For example, when we choose a school, to a large extent, the quality of a school is really determined by the quality of the professors and the teachers who are working in that university or school. Similarly here, the effectiveness of the teaching to some extent is going to be determined by the quality of the teacher. So generally speaking, the Buddha has outlined in various texts the kind of qualities that are necessary to the specific level of instructions, whether it is the master of a Vinaya practice or whether it is the master of a Vajrayana teachings, highest yoga tantra. In all of these cases, there are specific qualities that are mentioned by the Buddha. And here, in the Lamrim context, the teacher that we are looking for is someone who is able to impart instructions that would encompass the practices of all the three persons of all the three levels of capacities. The key qualities that are mentioned are the 10 qualities that are listed in Maitreya's ornament of Mahayana Sutras.
난디 도진이 농도마 차나 저기 수디 디스도가 그런 식으로 치기 태양 랑모 뒤에 신 뒤에 내매 벌써 배스 신 뒤에 라마테 토마 랑이 뒤뒤 오실 거 소스 치기 내모도가 균 뒤로 근데고 균 뒤로 태양 대 강 중중 그 주변 전에
So, in Tsongkhapa's text, which is on page 71 of volume 1, having cited a particular stanza from Maitreya's ornament of Mahayana Sutras, then Tsongkhapa writes the following. He says that it is said those who have not disciplined themselves have no basis for disciplining others. Therefore, gurus who intend to discipline others' mind must first have disciplined their own. How should they have been disciplined? It is not helpful for them to have done just any practice and then have the result designated as a good quality of knowledge.
They need a way to discipline the mind that accords with the general teachings of the Buddha. The three precious trainings are definitely such a way.
So this is quite a powerful statement, and Tsongkhapa is saying that the way in which the master should have disciplined his or her own mind is according to the teachings of the three higher trainings. So since the instruction we
are talking about,
so since instruction that we are talking about by which the students are being led to is instructions primarily related to the attainment of liberation, and since the principal practices and that constitute the path to liberation are really the practices of the three higher trainings. So therefore, on the part of the teacher who is giving such instruction, must himself or herself embody the knowledge of the three higher trainings. And since
the teacher is imparting an instruction that is not just for attainment of liberation, but also attainment of full enlightenment of the Buddhahood, therefore one needs to present a path that encompasses the practices of bodhicitta, great compassion, and so on. Therefore, the qualities relevant on the part of the teacher includes also having compassion and awakening mind.
So, and one of the qualities listed in Maitreya's text is realization of the suchness, or realization of ultimate truth. And this partly reflects a kind of a philosophical view of the author, because the presentation is according to the mind-only school, where a distinction is drawn between selflessness of person and ultimate reality. So the wisdom in the context of three higher trainings is identified with the wisdom of no self, and the additional quality, realization of suchness, refers to the mind-only school's understanding of realization of selflessness of phenomena. So when identifying the qualities relevant on the part of the student, Tsongkhapa identifies the three main qualities, being objective, endowed with the faculty of intelligence, and having the interest. So when searching for understanding the nature of reality, objectivity of a standpoint is very important, or the objective stance is very important, because otherwise one will be swayed by one's own biases and wishes. So therefore, it will come in the way of actually understanding the actual reality.
So 안데디 레셰 니셰 제베 남주도 담바 사디 네르 레셰 니셰리아 제바지스 고르바 레셰 니셰 카린디 도지스 고르바 제 도시 영화리아 남사 대박 지지 가는 거 싶으셔 저좀 챙겨야지 계속 또
So the second quality is the being endowed with intelligence. And intelligence here refers to critical intelligence, which has the ability to distinguish between what is right and what is wrong, what is correct and what is incorrect. And so the kind of intelligence we are talking about here is that of a critical inquiring type. And this suggests that at the beginning, one needs to have a form of skepticism, a kind of a doubt. Because when you have doubt and skepticism, then this will lead to questioning. And when you go through questioning, then there is a real possibility of leading to a deeper understanding of the facts. And therefore, when you, on the other hand, if you approach right from the beginning with a single-pointed faith, then it wouldn't open up the question. So having that skepticism and a critical intelligence becomes very important.
Benanam yuanda shun de shun zu mangshe ta mangshe ro sore kada kosa shi sun yung yare tini ni zane chir zhe du zhe di omu nambu tuni zhe dok zhe shen shi tini ni ba yindu shun de la jaja kari yare jaja di shi ne gaba kari yare te gaba za ma yinbe pu yingu kari yare 다 디디 도시 신지 고도가 디디 도시 전이 이 중들 쳐서 쉬어야지 자 디디 메 이제네 가서 쉬시 손대야 돼 계속 그래도
So and because of this if you look at many of the classical Indian text an emphasis has been made upon identifying what is the subject matter of a particular text what is the purpose of gaining the understanding of that subject matter And what is the long-term, ultimate purpose of gaining such knowledge? And then what is the interrelation between these three factors? And the point here is that because these texts are written for persons with critical faculty, and then a person with critical faculty, when they engage with the text, they're going to, first of all, check what is the main subject matter of the text, and what is the benefits and purposes, aims of gaining that knowledge, and what is the long-term final objective of these subject matter and so on.
Yeah. 오늘 최지전장 세계 치코레 고아디 여도와 최지전장 수준 소수도배 출전 음식이 실험이 되네 듣기도
So therefore even in the text we have expressions that relate to the different ways in which people engage with the text one is the those of slightly inferior faculty approach the text primarily from more of a faith and devotion, and those of a kind of a higher critical faculty of mind approaches a text more from the point of view of understanding the reality that is presented.
Yeah.